The Family Feud, introducing the Weyand family. Mary Ruth, TK, Bob, Valerie, and Dan, ready for action. And the Fiske family, Lori, Terry, Ed, Darlene, and Heidi, on your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard.
Champs are from Denver, and I love them right here. The Weyand. How much money did you win, Mary Ruth?
Oh, we won $5,608.
Oh, that's quite nice. Let's meet everybody.
Okay, this is my daughter-in-law, TK.
Hello.
Hi. She is married to my oldest son, Bob.
Hi. Roberto.
And next to him is my daughter, Valerie.
Hi, Richard.
The fast money player.
That's right. And down at the end is our youngest son, Dan.
And a handsome young man he is, too. TK, what does TK stand for, TK?
It stands for Teresa K, but my dad's called me TK when I was about 1 1/2, and it just stuck. So I've been called that ever since.
It's kind of nice.
It's different. I keep getting letters from the Army, but...
Well, yeah, that's right. I had a dog, Sarah, and she was registered with a pedigree, right? But that dogs don't have last names, so they put the owner's name. And it was Sarah Dawson. And Good Housekeeping wrote to her and said, for a young woman, a young businesswoman on the rise, this would be an excellent magazine for you to subscribe to. So I put two big dog biscuits in the envelope and mailed it back. I never heard from them again, as a matter of fact. Now, you're from near, I think, Sam, Sacramento? Where are you from?
Between Bakersfield and Fresno. We're from Tulare.
Because I know you had a terrible drive, didn't
right.
you? Tell us all about it. The Fixies are here. Didn't you get stuck?
Pardon?
Didn't you get stuck because of the bad weather?
Yes.
Let's meet everybody, then we'll find out about your ride.
Okay, this is my sister, Terry.
Hello,
Hi,
Kitty.
Richard.
And my brother-in-law, her husband, Ed.
Eduardo.
This is my sister, Darlene.
Hi,
Hello,
Richard.
Darlene.
And my baby sister, Heidi.
Hi, Richard.
Hello, Heidi. How old is Heidi?
15.
Yeah, she's a cutie pie. What happened to you? You were driving?
Yeah, and they closed the bridge, and so we just had to wait and wait and wait.
How long were you there?
About a couple hours, hour and a half.
Well, that's exciting. Are you probably
really.
Sang hymns or something?
No, we played Family Feud.
Oh, did you? What do you got in here?
We have some, we're Dutch descent. So
well,
we
nobody's
thought...
perfect. Don't put yourself down.
So we thought we'd bring you some Dutch windmill cookies.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you make them, though, or you buy them?
No, we bought them. At a Dutch bakery.
They're kind of neat, though. Is your folks, are they from Holland?
No.
Grandparents?
Yeah, my grandparents.
Somebody has to be, if you're Dutch descent. Legally speaking,
back
I believe. Come on, we're going to play the feud. Let's go! People surveyed, top six answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something wives always have to do that men should learn to do, too.
Yeah. Cook.
Cook.
Yeah. We're going to play, Richard.
We're going to play, darling. I'm very proud of you, honey. Very good. Hello, Terry.
Hi.
What should men learn to do? You know, because wives always have to learn to do these things.
Dishes, Richard.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Is that hard to learn? The
For
dishes.
Man, it is.
I've been doing it for 20 years. Ed, how you doing?
I'm pretty good.
Nice to see you. What would you say?
How about changing the baby's diaper?
Oh. It's diaper time. You got it. Have you done that, Ed?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, darling.
How about vacuum?
Okay. Yeah,
you're right.
Vacuum. it's something that wives always have to do that men should learn to do, too.
How about wash clothes?
Okay. Wash clothes!
Shopping. Grocery shopping.
You say you got it all, if not first try. Grocery shopping. No, not there. What should men learn to do, too? Come on, now.
Mm-hmm.
No girlish giggling.
How about send their kids to school?
Yeah, that's hard.
Good answer, good answer.
That's hard. Hard to learn how to do that. You just put them outside and close the door. Send the kids to school. Ed, put an end to this suspense, please. Something wives always have to do that men should learn to do, too.
The only thing I can think of is put the kids to bed.
All righty. If they're okay, and if not, third strike. Bedtime kids? Not there. Mary Ruth, there's $88 up there.
Driving the carpool.
Making the beds, carpooling.
Making the beds? All right. Making the beds.
Okay. Very simple. You get an orange crate, two nails, and a hammer. I've done it a million times. If it's there, you get the money. If not, you do make the bed. Number six, please. We'll be back.
It's
88. Plays nothing. Let's go.
Let's go.
People survey, top five answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something you see in a fitting room at a clothing store. Yeah.
Skirts.
That's where I get all of mine, by the way. Skirts. Oh. Something you see in a fitting room at a clothing store.
A mirror.
Thank you. Yeah. Mirror. Skirts.
Oh, boy.
How about a hook to hang your clothes
this
on?
This is marvelous.
Yeah, yeah, that's
awesome. Give them the hook. Yeah. Well done. What else would we find in there, madame?
What about a ledge to put your packages or your purse on?
Good, good, good.
Coming off the ledge.
Oh.
You meant a shelf ledge, didn't you? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, obviously. Everyone I've ever been into had one. I'm sorry, Dan. What are we going to find in a fitting room in a clothing store?
Well, you've got to have stalls to go in. So I'd say stalls. So people can't watch each other.
Takes a lot of the fun out of... And I hate it, too, when I stall. No? Mama.
Yes.
What will we see in a fitting room in a clothing store?
Pins.
Yeah. Okay, is there okay if not third strike? Pins. You got it.
Gotta be a stool to sit down on.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Good, good, good.
Again, if it's there, all right. If not, third strike. Somewhere to sit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, young Bob.
What about, I don't know if this is what Danny said, what about a curtain to close when you go into the room?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
That wasn't what Danny said.
I didn't know what
stall.
Danny said. Okay.
I have to tell you, I had very little idea, but I gathered a stall. Yeah. But if the curtain's there, you've got it. A very even game, if not third strike. And then the ladies get a chance to steal. Clayton! No. Number three. Lori, Lori, Lori. Give me an answer.
Measuring tape.
When the buzzer goes, I have to have an answer.
Okay.
What?
We want measuring tape.
The measuring tape button.
People survey, top seven answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that scares you when you're driving.
Bob. Someone pulls out right in front of you.
Yeah, someone pulls out in front. One answer, Ed, you'll beat it.
How about if a pedestrian jumps out in front of you?
Okay. A pedestrian jumps out. That's why I never go on the freeway. Those kids all jump out and... Very good, Eduardo.
Thank you.
Bad weather.
Okay.
All right, good answer. All right.
Bad weather. Don't even talk, I'll talk to hide it. Name something that scares you when you're driving.
How about too many cars on the road?
Too many, just too much traffic?
Yeah.
There's too much traffic. Oh, not that. Okay, Lori.
Okay, how about if you see a wreck up ahead?
Yeah. Good answer.
Al Recco.
How about like when animals run on the road right in front of you? Okay.
Even when they run behind, I get nervous. Animals! No. Edward, what scares you when you're driving?
How about when you hear a siren?
Good answer!
And you know deep in your heart it's not Broderick Crawford. Siren!
What
scares you when you're driving?
Would, like, people... following you and, you know, giving you weird looks be like a bad driver?
A weirdo, right?
Yeah.
I should have used a medical term. If it was there, all right, and if not, third strike. A weirdo. Nope. $71. Mary Ruth?
A blowout.
What do you say, Mulla?
A blowout.
A blowout. I don't know if it's there, you get the $71. If not, a big lead for you, Angel. Blowout! Six. You're on driver. 249 to nothing. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a dentist's instruction you pay no attention to.
Yeah. Don't eat no sweets.
Sweets. Don't eat them. Two answers will beat it.
Floss your teeth every day.
Floss every day. You got it. Every day.
Play.
Okay.
Very good, eh?
Let's go. Come
on. Floss every molar. The dentist instruction you pay no attention to, Daniel.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, the way you brush. You know, he always tells you to brush a certain way.
The way you brush your teeth?
Yeah.
Boop. Nice way to get in the game. What do you say? Give it to me right now.
Oh, boy.
A dentist instruction you pay no attention to.
Pay no attention to. 6 month checkups.
No, what?
6 month checkups.
We'll cut all that rubbish out. Where you went? Uh-oh. 6 month checkup for all the money?
Yeah!
249, 162, let's go! Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top three answers on the board. This will decide it. Here we go. Name something in the kitchen children are cautioned to be careful with. Yep.
stove.
The stove. What are we going to do?
We're playing.
We're playing. Very good, Heidi.
Hi, Heidi.
My ears and three Dobermans went out with that squeal. I'm going to read this once. I will not repeat it. When I get to you, you have 3 seconds to answer. Here it is. Name something in the kitchen children are cautioned to be careful with.
Knives. Sharp knives.
Knives. 3 seconds.
How about be careful with the dishes?
Right. For the championship dishes? Oh. 3 seconds, Ed.
How about the chairs and the table furniture?
Don't give me lots of answers. Chairs!
What about the cords hanging down like
Alrighty.
The
toast? If it's there, you got it. If not, they got a chance to keep their title. The cords. Nope. 270, you'll keep your title if you
poison,
give me the right
poison
answer.
Poison liquids. Poison.
Something in the kitchen children are cautioned to be careful with.
All right, poisonous things under the sink. Cleaning fluids.
Poison. If it's there, you've got it. One more time. If not, you're the new champs. Poison. I would say, like, pots and pans of boiling water and stuff like, but I don't know. We'll take a look. Number 3. Matches. Okay. Well, I'd be going back to Denver with you, wouldn't I? $162 plus $5,608. But I'm delighted because you had a second chance and it paid off for you.
Sure did.
Thank you.
Safe flight home. Push. Laurie and Ed are going for the money right after we watch this. Wish you luck.
Thank you.
We'd love you to win the money.
Thank you.
15 seconds for Laurie, please. Name the sport in which athletes have the shortest career.
Baseball.
The most you'd pay for shoes.
$20.
A term of endearment.
Love.
Something you see in the sky.
Birds.
Something people put in pancakes.
Water.
Fine. Turn around. You've been using that pancake mix again, haven't you? Sport in which athletes have the shortest career. I would have said the low jump. You said, baseball, survey said. Most you pay for shoes. $20, right? Yeah. Of course, they've hardened paper a lot now, so you probably, they'd last a week or two now. Survey said. 5. Term of endearment, love. Survey. 15. Something you see in the sky. A void. Survey said. 5. Now, doesn't she get an award for 4 fives?
Yeah.
Get the 4-5 award.
Oh, I know.
Something people put in pancakes, and my favorite, water pancakes, I love them. Particularly when you're in the Sahara Desert. If you're ever in the Mojave Desert, a water pancake is one of the best things you can have. No, people use it to mix up the flour.
Well, instant pancakes.
They do indeed.
Yeah.
It could be there. Survey's up. Zippo. Off you go. Go and stand right next to Terry. And we're looking for Eduardo. Not a strong showing, but it doesn't matter. You're already the champs. Do the best you can. Please remind Laurie. Answer. I think you gave us at least one. And 20 seconds on the clock. Name the sport in which athletes have the shortest career.
Football.
The most you pay for shoes.
$30.
A term of endearment.
Love.
Try again.
Honey.
Something you see in the sky.
Clouds.
Something people put in pancakes.
Buttermilk.
Okay. Turn around. You did very well.
Thank you.
Sport in which athletes' shortest career, football, you said. Number 1 answer, survey said. much you paid for shoes? 30 clams, you said. Serve it. All righty. $50 was the number one answer, believe it or not. Term of endearment, you said, honey. It was number one. Survey said 34. Something you see in the sky, you said clouds. Number one. Survey said 34. Something to pull in pancakes. Number one answer was blueberries. And you said buttermilk. If it's worth 37, you got the money. Survey said 7. $170, $5 every point. Total of $850. You will return. You scored $130. They're Dutch, you know. We all make them feel at home for me. Say tulip. Get out of it. We'll see you here on the feud. Bye-bye.
Moist chocolate chip cake. Incredibly moist with lots of real chocolate chips. Another way you and Benny Crocker can make someone happy. A great selection of fashion right shoes from Kinney, the great American shoe store. Who can bring you all the latest styles at down-to-earth prices? Kinney can. The new Kodamatic Champ instant camera gives you brilliant color by Kodak in pictures that develop right before your eyes. Pledge gives furniture a clearly more beautiful shine. Doesn't your wood furniture deserve Pledge every time you dust? This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.